My son made this beautiful breakfast for me. Yummy. I really didn't have an appetite this morning. Just the way I like it, the way my mom makes it. My son made it. Milk, butter, sugar, grits. And that shower was exhilarating. I just got out the shower. And I'm gonna try to get, looks like I don't have to try. My appetite is coming now. The good news is I have an appetite. Hopefully it is good news. Because when you have a high immune system, overactively high, there is no appetite because there's not enough blood. So the bad news is the only other way, there's two ways I could, possibilities why I have an appetite. One is obvious. The bad one would be if somehow I contracted some kind of horrible virus, which the doctors tell me is mainly not possible because lupus eats germs like snack. Basically, I'm gonna keep doing these MP3 videos, MP4, until I perfect it. Until I don't see any jittering in the video, any stagnation, and the sound is the way it, as it should be, then I'll be ready for YouTube. Very good. And other media. We all have personal life, you know? And it's not always good. That's reality of this planet and the flesh. You know, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is always cooking up something negative going on. Distractions is all that is. Right now, no matter what happens, I will not be distracted from this media purpose and cause and effect, okay? Because it's very important. My son made me this breakfast. I didn't even have to ask him. It's so nice to have grown kids that do beautiful things for their parents. It's a wonderful thing. No, you know, I really thank you, Robina Perry, for being my friend. You're always there when I need you. You're always there no matter what day it is, no matter what time it is. You always answer my calls. You never judge me. You know, you never negative. You know, it's not always sweet as pie. Because, you know, some things are not sweet as pie when it's real. You know, that would be fake. But you're always there for me. And I needed a friend like you. You know, because when I was growing up, I was a tomboy. And then when I had children, I had to be the mother and the father. Didn't have to. I wanted to be that way. And then I had to. I was independent since I was 14 paying rent. I'm proud of it. But when you're that independent, there's no time to be girly, girly, girly. And there's not any time to be social all the time, laughing and joking and playing and going to parties and all that. When you're very serious about being responsible. And I've always been very responsible. And yes, I have 19 siblings, 18, I make 19. But I didn't grow up with them in the same house. That makes a difference in how you communicate with people. This is logic. I understand logic. But people who are used to being in a situation where they grew up with kids in the house, they have different way of communicating with people. Not just to know how to communicate on a job, or which I can always do that because I've always did work when I was young. And not how you communicate with children, because I've always done that when I was young. Because if there were siblings in the house, they were so much younger than me, like a decade younger, that was definitely not building my communication skills, except with younger, teaching, things like that, you know? And I accept that, and I know these things about myself. But now that I'm gonna be in the media, and I am going to accept this, because I've always had the opportunity to be part of the media and chose not to. But now I choose to, because my son and my brother Rob has given me a reason to participate with the media in a positive way that has cause and effect. And that's important. Now, I have spent all night talking to two male professors who teach at UMass. They teach sociology. And I figure I'm going to need a little bit of that now, because I'm somewhat of an invert, and I never have a problem with that. But now it's really important for me to be more outgoing socially, and I accept that. I want it that way now. And so basically, like I said, I'm going to keep making these videos until the jittering stops, the hesitation stops in the video, the music doesn't slow down or pause, or the video doesn't pause. I'm going to keep doing this until I perfect this. Because when I perfect this, which won't take very long. Hi, Anthony. I'm going to be all over the media doing what I do best, which is singing a song that is effective in a positive way. For cause and effect purposes only, you know. So basically, I have joined these social groups that are part of a leadership social club, because to be alone a lot and not to follow the crowd when you're young and when you're older, and not to want to do what everybody else is always doing, it only means one thing. It means that you are a leader. lead, follow, or get out of the way. And I always like to, when I say lead, I don't mean leading others my way. I mean leading myself, period. I don't follow the crowd. I don't wear what everybody else is wearing. I don't do what everybody else is doing. I don't speak the way everyone else speaks to stay in the in crowd. I never did. And I probably never will. What I do want to understand more about the sociology and communication, I do want to understand a little bit more about it. Not to be like anyone else, just to understand, to become deeper in my purpose, to be more effective. And that's where I can become more of what I am, but in a more effective way, like I said, predominantly positive. Even when there's negative things going on, I always want to try. I'm always going to try. And my appetite. I didn't have an appetite this morning because I was too full of thinking and learning. I really thank you, Robina, for being my friend. Because, you know, I've been so to myself inverted all my life and independently. And I need a female like you so I could get out some of that girly parts of me. Because you definitely have that. But I really thank you because you don't judge me and you are like me where you're always looking for positive things in negative situations. And you're always there when I call you. You're always answering the phone. You're always picking me up. If I say come get me, you come get me. If I don't say come get me, you say you want me to come get you. All the way from Worcester, you come pick me up, bring me to Worcester, whatever. You're a really beautiful person, Robina Perry. And I'm glad that God put you in my life. Some people have a hard time understanding me because of my social skills. Grown people. But, you know, grown people who are used to being from a big family of children, siblings. But you never have a problem with understanding me at all. You seem to be like a spiritual sister that God has given. You never ignore my calls. You're always available. Even if you're asleep, you will wake up for me. And you don't even say, I was sleeping, until I say, are you sleeping? And I appreciate you. And I am. My son is about to come upstairs. And he's going to download some movies into my computer because I don't have the internet on at my apartment right now at this moment because I chose not to. He's going to download some movies for me. He's going to show me how to do it. So when I go home, I have all these new movies in my computer that I can watch on my television set tonight. You know? I was gonna go out to the social club tonight for leaders. But I don't think that's gonna happen tonight. So I guess I'll be watching movies tonight. My son is coming up here to download for me new movies. All new movies. I can't wait. And good, bad, scary, whatever. Mostly, I could watch a couple of movies, but I just want them to be there when I want to see them. So I don't watch TV that much anymore. Now that I'm into my music. And I love this, what I'm doing with my son, Andre Johnson, and Robert Keith. You know, they have given me a great purpose for my voice. And, you know, they have empowered me. I have sang with many people. People have heard me sing and they want me to come and sing with them. And they want me to sing what they want me to sing. That's cute and all of that. But usually it's nothing positive. It's love songs, sad songs, cheating songs. You know, the normal stuff. I was never happy singing that kind of stuff. Though I like a little bit of it, but now I listen to instrumentals without words. Not instrumentals of songs that are familiar. Instrumentals like I put up this morning, the Best of Jazz Lounge. Those songs are not songs of they're not instrumentals of any love songs or sad songs or anything like that that I've ever heard. They're just instrumentals that I've never had words to them, except for the first one that says, "Have you ever seen a sunset? It's full of hope and answers. Let yourself go free and vitro and full of good vibrations." You know, I like those kind of things. Those are positive things that cause me to think more about empowering myself more. Not to be liked by anybody. Just to feel good feelings inside my head and my heart and my soul, most of all, my spirit. Also, it helps you hear your own music. Your own music that God has given for you to create. And that's what I want. And I really thank my son, Andrew Johnson, and Robert Keith for this opportunity, because I had almost given up on even just doing any kind of music or singing at all, because I couldn't find a satisfaction. And even in church, I love church, I did, but when it comes to singing in the choir, they only let me sing. I've been to many religions. They only let me sing to impress other churches or to make themselves look better than other churches. And that didn't make me feel, it did for a while, but then it wears off. You know, that's not what God made me for. God didn't make me to show off for someone else or to make someone else jealous or anything like that. I don't want to waste my voice that way. That's why I could never go really far with it, because I didn't want to, not that way. Now, I can't say it enough. I'm really happy about what's going on with me, Andre Johnson, and Robert Keith. with the music, positive. You know, it just it gives me bigger purpose for my voice. And for that, I do have to develop more social skills, because they have people who have heard me that wanted me to come into their studios and pay me. And I became inverted, because I am inverted, and I'm like, no, I'm not going. I didn't go, not even for the money. So I have to develop that social thing for those reasons. And I'm gonna try to get my appetite going. I feel my stomach growling a little bit. But my brain, food for thought, as they say, food for the soul, is craving more than my stomach right now. So, let's see how this MP4 turned out. Peace, love, and light.